Now, right at this very moment, there are all kinds of unusual things happening in our oceans, including an invasion of blue intruders on Australia's east coast.
Our favourite marine biologist, Cherie Maris, is here to explain it all. Hello, Cherie, darling.
Hi, how are you?
Good. Cherie, first up, these strange blue invaders. What are they?
I know, people are kind of losing their mind and making them seem really sinister, but they're actually fascinating animals. They're open ocean dwelling sea slugs. And a lot of people call them blue dragons, and they're incredible, these metallic looking like sea slugs. And they're actually not that big. They're between 1.5 and 4 centimetres. So they're not big at all, but they're amazing. They're like marine thieves. They steal the life from the food that they eat, as well as their weapons, and they use it in their own arsenal. So I think this event is pretty amazing because usually we wouldn't see them, but these strong northeasterlies have actually pushed them up onto our shore so we can get a bit of a glimpse.
Are they related to blue bottles? Do they hurt you at all?
They're not related to blue bottles. They are found in the same place, so open ocean, but they're a type of sea slug. But the interesting thing is that these sea slugs actually eat blue bottles. So they eat the blue bottles, and then they take the venomous harpoons or the nematocysts from the blue bottles and they use it in their own arsenal as a defence mechanism. So how cool is that?
It's unreal.
Awesome.
And speaking of blue bottle, we all know the rumour of how you can treat a blue bottle sting. Is that true?
The rumour, are you talking about peeing on a blue bottle sting?
Look, you said it, Cherie, not me, yes. I'm very classy.
Well, no, I would not recommend. Well, I'm not, so I can say it. No, don't pee on it. The first aid treatment they recommend is use vinegar. Also, scientists have discovered if you haven't got access to vinegar, use hot water or warm water, because that will actually delay or stop those little venomous harpoons that cause that sting and pain to actually eject. So, if you get stung, vinegar or warm water is the way to go.
Oh, great stuff.
Sorry to disappoint you, Tristan.
No, that's all right. Staying on that topic. Fascinating animal we talked about before, Cherie, the penis worm. And there's some new science about their evolution.
Worm.
Yeah. Can you tell us about that there? What do you reckon?
Of course I can. Any chance to talk about a penis worm, I'm all for it. What's really interesting, penis worms have been around for a very long time, 500 million years, and they've just found a penis worm that actually was living in a shell, which is really fascinating. And they call animals, when animals live in a shell or use a protection, they call it hermiting. And it's the first evidence of an animal actually
using that.
From a penis worm perspective, it makes sense because they're really soft and squishy, so lots of predators eat them. So they kind of invented the hermiting before the hermit crab, which also has a soft body and is renowned for using old shells to kind of protect itself, coming along. So they were just kind of copycats. The penis worm actually led the charge when it comes to hermiting and a lot of other stuff, which I won't say.
Do they get smuggled a lot? I'd imagine a lot of snorkelers might put them in a backpack or something. Are they endangered?
No, they're not, but they provide lots of entertainment. And the penis worm was named after the fact that it's very phallic-looking. Yeah. Let's just address the elephant in the room. But the phylum which it's found, so it's a Greek name which actually refers to the male anatomy. So, it looks like that, so they've called it that, and I think it's great. And this is another reason why I love nature, because it's just so bizarre.
Yeah. I think that's where Dumbo came from as well.
True, here's something I've always wondered. Why don't whales drown when they open their mouths so wide to feed? Scientists have just answered that question, I've heard.
Yeah, they have, and it's a really great question. And if you look at the feeding methods of baleen whales or filter feeding whales, they're the ones that have those massive mouths with the expandable throat plates, and they can swallow volumes of water that's basically the same size as themselves. A blue whale can swallow over 80,000 litres, but they have this special kind of oral plug in their mouth which prevents the water going in from the top, but they've also, their larynx closes off as well, so that prevents water going in too. So it's like having a plug in your mouth, pretty much.
Oh, wow. Speaking of whales, though, Cherie, this is a bit random, but how do whales sleep?
Good question. Great question. Yeah.
Well, they do sleep, yeah. It's like us, you know, we're mammals, they're mammals. They sleep underwater and sometimes at the surface, but unlike us, where breathing kind of comes naturally, they actually have to remember and think to breathe. So when they're sleeping, half of their brain goes to sleep and the other half of their brain stays awake, as if to say, okay, I've got to remember, I need to come up to breathe. And when they're sleeping, it's so incredibly beautiful. They call it logging because it looks like these logs just kind of either lying vertically in the water like sperm whales or, you know, at the surface. So, yeah, pretty magical animals. And if they didn't have this mechanism, they would actually drown.
Wow. It's fascinating. Unreal. Looking at them there. That scared the bejesus out of me when you're swimming down there.
Yeah, I know. I can't believe we're at our age and that it's the first time I've ever seen a sleeping whale.
I couldn't think of anything better.
Oh, no, it looks beautiful for sure, yeah.
Everyone needs a sleeping whale.
That's it. It's unreal.
Sheree, we can see them at the surface, which is really good.
Oh, great. It's always a pleasure speaking to you. I love talking to you. Thanks so much for your time today.
Pleasure. Thank you.